Sandro, sono molto contento di
Sandro, how nice to see you for the MASI Awards in San Giorgio Valpolicella. I'm so glad to see you too, and it is now the tradition of autumn here in San Giorgio. This is a fantastic little village with a fantastic belvedere on the vineyards, on the olive groves, up to the Garda Lake, and there is a very prestigious Middle Ages castle. It is a pre-Romanic, Romanesque, and it comes before the Roman Empire, and it is the historical center, the cultural and spiritual center of our valley, and not only of our valley, but also of the neighborhood, the area up to the Garda Lake on the one side and Verona to the other. Here we have our roots, and not only our roots, but also our perspectives. Here in front of us, we see them, and we need to have the possibility to aim at the future. But these two words, roots and perspectives, shouldn't be dealt with now, because we are going to get into depth in a little while. We are going to get into the parish church and discover who the winners are. And we are very curious to listen to them and what their roots are, to describe their perspectives.
Buonasera. Buonasera a tutti quanti.
Good evening, buonasera. Everybody.
Benvenuti.
And welcome.
Benvenuti alla 42esima.
Welcome to the 42nd edition of the MASI Award. I changed my suit like David Copperfield, and I want to greet all the participants, all the attendees, starting from our winners, the authorities, as well as the members of the MASI Foundation, and all those who are not attending here physically, that are following us from the social media, from Facebook, Instagram, MASI Wines, or the MASI website, and also from Tele Arena. Well, I would like to introduce, first of all, Mr. Sandro Boscaini, with a big round of applause. He changed his suit rapidly as well. Here we are. Dear Sandro, this year it is an international award. It is going to be a trip around the world. Well, particularly, we have our roots, we have our champions of a bond with these roots that went around the world through the winners, the Venetian winners. And also we went out to discover, thanks to our chairwoman and the juries who work very hard and well, of personalities both for the International Wine Civilization Award and the Grosso d'Oro Veneziano. And this year we went to Iran and to Japan. And so we are going to discover a lot, but we don't want to say anything in advance. So thank you very much. Please go back to your seat, and then we are going to talk together again. And welcome to all the participants from my side, too. And also, I would like to greet the authorities, and I would like to invite a friend of MASI Award, the mayor of Verona, Tommaso Miani. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It is an honor to be here.
Soprattutto a rappresentare la città, il nome della nostra città.
And I represent the name of our town and the excellence of our town. The title of this celebration, Roots and Perspectives, is very interesting. We have a special carrot here in this area, but we shouldn't only consider our roots, we should also look at our perspectives. and our outlooks. We are linked to our roots. Sometimes we lose sight of our perspectives. Sometimes we have to be brave, and we have to be aware of our roots. But in order to see far away, sometimes we have to let our roots go to see even further. Thank you very much, Mr. Damiano Tomasi, Mayor of Verona. And now we have another mayor. We are in a beautiful Romanesque Paris church. And here we have Mr. Roberto Zorzi, Mayor of San Giorgio Valpolicella. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to our little village of San Giorgio, which was very well described by Mr. Boscaini. I greet him and I thank him for what he brought to us from Valpolicella and to the world. Everyone used their competencies well to do this work. I would like to thank the juries and the foundation because it is a very important work in order to have some important recognitions of world level. Today, Valpolicella, thanks to this award and to the MASI sellers, is known all over the world. Today we are in a splendid Paris church. It is made of marble, and in our territory we find marble and wine, and wines, especially Amarone, took us to the world, to all over the world. And so everything, this ceremony that is going to take place tonight is going to be of world level. Thank you very much, Mr. Mayor, and thank you for your contribution. And the governor of the Venetian region, Mr. Zaia, could not come here, and he sent a letter to the foundation. I would like to read a piece of it.
Mr. Zaia writes, the prize, whose title is Roots and Perspective, shows the farsightedness with which Masi and the Boscaini family believed in this project of culture and value. Culture and entrepreneurship are not so far apart. Indeed, they are mingling and mutually fueling, creating a strong connection which allows a territory to grow, with a key feature which is the entrepreneurial culture made by values, excellence, and love for our Mother Earth and for one of its produce, which is the outcome of hard work, our wine. Therefore, our connection with our roots is important since they define our community and its identity, which remains the same throughout the years and lays down a solid base of our future. I wish to thank you all for your consistent and hard work to promote our culture with my very best wishes. So the governor said so. Roots and perspectives is the theme. It seems a rather contrasting idea. In actuality, we will prove tonight that they will go hands in hands. And I would like to show you this video to prove it.
Thank you.
At a time where uncertainty is filling thoughts and behaviors, you have to get to the roots, which is the certainty of having the feed for the future. These images were wonderful, and also the final statement by Isabella Bossi Ferigotti, the chairwoman of the foundation, whom I would like to invite here and ask her why roots and perspectives. Roots and perspectives is like saying tradition and innovation. These are two words that sounds contradictory, and it is the very contradiction that allows for growth. We all know that. Masi is aware of it since quite some time, because this is part of our DNA. And also our winners, seems to me, are in line with these two words. Last thing that I wanted to say, we, the members of the jury, sometimes wonder, are we good or are we just lucky to have such marvelous winners? We are going to discover that, because the great deal of current affairs in the list of the winners. Well, thank you very much, Madam Isabella Bossi Fedegotti, the chairwoman of the Masi Foundation. Curiosity must be filled. Because we have seen something, a hint on the video, but I shall indeed give the announcement of the International Masi Prize Grosso d'Oro, which is for people who have contributed to disseminate the message of culture in the world with understanding amongst peoples, developing in solidarity, civil progress, and peace. The citation is for the high artistic value of her work and her upholding of civil rights and democracy in the Iranian society. She has been able to describe the dramatic events of her country and her commitment for the defense of civil rights and democracy in the Iranian society. The International Prize Grosso d'Oro Veneziano is being awarded to Madame Rakhshan Banietemad.
Benvenuta.
Welcome.
Benvenuta e grazie.
Welcome and thank you very much for being here.
Non è un caso questo bel
This applauso. Is not by chance that the round of applause is so long.
Grazie davvero.
Thank you most wholeheartedly for being here, madam, and thanks also to Michele Marelli, who's helping us with the translation. Madam, but if we think about women in Iran, we're rather worried about them. Do you have a thought and that stems from this prize? First of all, I would like to say that I'm very happy to be here in Verona for the second time in my life in this wonderful city, which is so filled with beauty. And I thank most wholeheartedly the Masi Foundation as well as the members of the jury for the award. This prize, first of all, is a prize that I want to share with all the women in particular who were for me a source of inspiration in the production of my films.
سینماگر برجسته ایرانی داریوش مهرجویی که متاسفانه اخیراً قربانی خشونت شد به موزه سینمای ایران میسپرم تا برای همیشه به یادگار بمونه.
And I also would like to share this prize to the memory of a Doresh Medri, a very important film director who has been violently killed a few days back, and I will give my prize to the Iranian Cinema Museum so that it will be there in his memory forever. Thank you very much. Much to Madame Rakhshan Banietemad. Please take a seat with Michele Marelli behind her.
Let's carry on with the winners of the Venetian Civilization Award, which is in a recognition of celebrities born in the Venetian region, so originating from or adopted by a Venetian family, outstanding in literature, arts, or journalism, science, or show business, or economics, who valued the skills of Venetian people in the widest area of human activities and promoted the values of the Venetian regions. And the citation for his activity as a lexicographer for the dissemination of, also among the new generations, the idea that the Italian language is a living and evolving organism that cannot be arbitrarily deformed or preserved artificially. The prize awards is attributed to Mr. Mario Cannella. Professor, thank you very much for coming. Thank you. We're going to get in depth, but when we say that the language is not stiff but is dynamic, what does it mean? That everything flows and also the language flows. When I was a boy, I used to go to Trieste port because I come from Trieste, and I observed the people unloading the ships, and I never imagined that we could have downloaded files or movies like we did with luggage or boxes, even our conscious. Well, we do so even now, you know. Yes, you're right, but very interesting. Okay, please take a seat in the second chair, and then we are going to get into depth. Well, there are some interesting things to say, and the second award goes to an engineer. He was a pioneer in eco-hydrology and studied the relationship between rivers, fresh water, and living communities, animals and plants, with the objective of distributing water equally, which is one of the most difficult issues at the moment. Mr. Andrea Rinaldo is the winner. He is a Nobel Prize also. Okay, and I neglect the fact that you are, you know, a water engineer, but you are winning a wine award, but you are Venetian, and so water is in your destiny, isn't it? Yes, absolutely. I grew up in Venice. And Venice certainly leaves a sign because water saves you but can destroy you. I was 9 years old when I saw the high water in Venice, and you know, talking about perspectives, this is important. Thank you very much, Mr. Rinaldo. Please take your seat.
Because I would like to introduce the third winner, and the citation is this: for having made successful a company that from a glass blowing company became a world leading company in the pharmaceutical sector with top specialization such as insulin, vaccines, and many other drugs, the Premio Masi for Venetian Civilization to the chairman, Mr. Franco Stevanato. Thank you, Mr. Chairman, to you and the rest of your company, of course. Given that you are so much connected to the local territory, but with a worldwide vision, my question is, choosing between roots and perspectives, what's top? You have heart and head in the roots and curiosity and hunger into perspectives. Well, a perfect guest of a talk show gave us a wonderful definition. Thank you, Mr. Stevanato. Please take a seat here on my right-hand side because we are at the International Masi Prize for Wine Civilization devoted to viniculture and wine growing. It awards the most significant personality who praised the ancient wine culture. And I read the citation for their important contribution to the understanding of an ancient culture of wine through their manga, The Drops of God, involving also an audience made by non-expert with a new original and brand new communication, the Masi Prize is awarded to Yuko and Shin Kibayashi.
Grazie.
Thank you most wholeheartedly for being here. Well, arigato. I was in Japan last summer, so I have to show off. This is the only word that I know in Japan. Thank you for being here. And first of all, I'd like to ask a question to Madam Yuko. Manga are gaining momentum in Italy as well among young people, but the Japanese tradition comes from very far, isn't it?
イタリアでも、リボンの騎士とか鉄腕アトムとか、それまでは4コマの漫画をただ同じ絵が並んでるような漫画だったんですけれども、ドラマのように擬音が入ったり、近づいて撮ったり、あるいはこう遠くから撮ったりっていう映画のような形で表現する形式っていうのが生まれたのが、手塚治虫から始まって、そこから日本の漫画の伝統が始まりました。
Absolutely, yes. You have to think that the manga tradition goes back to the 50s. Most likely, the Italian audience is aware of a great manga artist, Tezuka Kozan. We know that in Italy, his own production was being appreciated through some products that have been brought here, like the Sapphire Princess and others. Before his contribution, mangas normally were short stories with we added perspectives and indeed we made the manga as we developed them over the years. Among others, I would like to ask Mr. Shin Kibayashi, in Japan you have an international manga museum in Kyoto, which I visited. Everyone should visit it. This means how important is the manga culture in Japan, isn't it?
そうですね。漫画という文化は日本にとって、ゲームと並んで世界に輸出できる本当に偉大なものの一つだと思ってます。京都の博物館もよく知ってます。僕はそこで講演会やったこともあります。
Oh, certainly, yes. The manga culture is very important in Japan. For instance, another culture that was developed a lot was video games. So these are cultures that we have exported over time. And yes, the Kyoto Museum is very important from that particular point of view. I have lectured there on several occasions. So please do take a seat. We also thank Mr. Giuseppe Gervasio, who's helping us in translating, and I also would like to say hello. You're not seeing them, but Mrs. Marina Fracchia and Mr. Paolo Maria Noseda, who every year translates our event into English for those who are following us online. Thank you very much indeed.
Allora,
Now, ladies and gentlemen, as you see, we have lots of very interesting issues to address. I will give the floor to Madame Banietemad. Being a film director, being a woman, and talking about civil rights, how complicated is it in Iran right now? Well, I have to say that when you talk about being a film director and being a woman, one has to say that in the job itself, there is no difference between man and woman. But if you choose to describe social issues, which is what I have chosen, well, we are indeed faced with more evident difficulties. I'd like to ask you another question. We're all worried for the wars going on, etc. So I'd like to indeed know from your own perspective in Iran and what you think about such a hard time.
نتونسته با دیالوگ مشکلاتش رو حل کنه. آدم فکر میکنه با پیشرفت تکنولوژی و فناوری و این همه پیشرفت تو عرصه‌های مختلف چطور ممکنه که زبان بین ملت ها جنگ باشه. متنفرم.
Hatred, hatred, hatred. I hate the war. The question that I constantly ask myself is, how is it possible that in the 21st century, a century where we have reached a very advanced level when it comes to science and technology, we haven't as yet found a language, and in particular, we haven't as yet reached a method which would allow to solve problems through dialogue among people. I hate personally the war. Yes, there was the word hatred that you have repeated several times, which really makes an impact on all of us. But I would like to involve Professor Rinaldo when it comes to war, because he is a water engineer, and he usually launches projects to help mankind. But sometimes water is the source of wars. But it is really the most precious element that we have and keep and have to keep? And why is it that we don't understand it? Well, it's always happened in human history. There was a scientific work that was being made some 10 years ago and published on Nature, showed a direct correlation between archaeological relics proving the number of people killed in tribal time and the level of the water of Lake Kibo. We're in Africa here, but where the adventure of the Homo sapiens started. And this is very much connected with human nature. The conflict when it comes to water, for instance, a scientist, a social scientist, used to say that the rate of freedom of a company is inversely proportional to the size of their rivers. Water has always been the source of battles, and water has always been gone hands in hands with history, and water is really at the center of history. I have to tell the truth. In reality, some of the areas bring about conflicts which are still ongoing. Also, the so-called fertile half moon and the passage of man from peasant to hunter. Why? Because because the rivers Tigris and Euphrates are originated in Turkey. Well, a few cities disappeared because of desalination. The great Mesopotamian civilization disappeared because they did not know how to desalt water, and we see it in Gaza as well. So I would jump on Professor Stevanato, and we're out from a global emergency, which we don't want even to mention, and you, as a pharmaceutical company, have been accused to make profit out of pandemics. Indeed, you produce drugs, things that save us and are the very picture of progress. What would you answer when you're accused? First of all, we give packaging to pharmaceuticals, so we support the pharmaceuticals. The pharmaceutical industry helps you to increase your life expectancy, and more and more populations in the world are not yet receiving treatments like insulin or tumor drugs, etc., or drugs that play a role on your weight and take away the risk of infarction. What we're trying to do very humbly is to serve with a great deal of quality to support the pharmaceutical companies to improve life expectancy of the whole populations in the world. This is a fundamental issue. But if I would ask you what to do to avoid a situation that we had already gone through, what is the emergency at global level? What is an emergency right now? What we learned after the last tragedy of the last 3 years with COVID is to have preventative supply chains in parallel may help the preparation and the launching of a vaccine on the market. This was the lesson learned of all the pharmaceuticals and countries. Prepare research centers so that you can develop vaccine more quickly, and so production, packaging, and distribution can be carried out more quickly. In a case of a crisis such as COVID, the number of deaths will be dramatically reduced. Let's hope not.
Going back to roots and perspectives, I believe that nobody could be better than a lexicographer to explain what it means, because the language is synonym to roots like Dante, Boccaccio, you know. Am I forgetting someone? Well, I would say so. Well, I just mentioned two of them. Okay, perspectives. Now we have AI, we have the computers, we have social media. So between these two things, so roots and perspectives, so what is the place of a language? As you said, the roots of a language are numerous. There are the three crowns, Dante, Petrarca, and Boccaccio, and then Pietro Bembo, who, however, valued Petrarca for poetry and Boccaccio, and less so Dante, who used a more vulgar language, and then Galilei, and then Manzoni, who went to Florence to learn the language there. And then, there, you know, being a lexicographer is a frontier work, because the lexicographer studies the language with the aim of producing vocabularies. So it is between the lexicon and the large public, and studying the vocabularies. We have this problem. After after the 90s, and I have been working in this field for over 40 years. At the beginning, the vocabulary was used in one way, but in the last 20 years, the use of vocabularies has changed, and our perspective are according to the evolution of the world, as you said, AI, social media, and so on and so forth, defending the value of the vocabulary against Google, where you look for words. But the vocabulary is a book. It has a value on its own, you know, per se. I will tell you that a friend of mine came to us and said, my daughter asked for a vocabulary and asked her mother how she could read a vocabulary. Yes, I know that the youth, you know, has difficulties in reading. You read a dictionary, you know. I know. Okay, thank you very much, Professor. Mr. Cannella.
And talking
about a language which is very strongly bonded to roots is manga in Japan. And I would like to know how the interest for wine was created, because wine is not a traditional Japanese drink. I don't know who of you wants to answer this question.
ワインは日本ではそれほど当時飲まれてなかったんですね。まあ、僕らはでもワインが大好きで、若い頃から飲んでいて、で、ある一つのワインをきっかけにワインに非常にハマってしまって、で、姉と二人で別の漫画の仕事を原作者なんですけども、押しながらワインを飲んでいたんですね。で、その時、お互いにそのワインのイメージみたいなものを 人に例えてみたり、自然の光景に例えてみたりしながら語り合ってたんです。で、ある時ふと僕思ったんですよね。これもしかしたら漫画になるんじゃないかな。僕らが感じているようなものを飲み手が全然世界の端っこにいる人でも同じように感じることができるんだったら、全世界の共通言語のようにワインを用いて、それを漫画として取り入れて全世界に 日本だけじゃなく伝えることができたら夢のような話だななんて、そんなところから始まった漫画です。
Yes, it is true. In that period in Japan, certainly we couldn't say that wine was the alcoholic drink which was more popular, but we participated in tastings, wine tastings, and we discovered wine in particular, and that became, for me and my sister, the opportunity to start talking about wine. We are now dealing with another manga, but that was the opportunity to get to know that wine, and that led us to talk about that wine. We could talk about a natural panorama, or we could talk about the memory of a person. We wanted to create some visual images, and that images could be translated into a manga. And I think that many people who drink wine have the possibility of perceiving the same things. And so the wine language can become a common world language. And this was the dream that we saw, and that became the basis for the creation of that manga. And I would like to add that they sold millions of copies of their manga, not 50,000, not 100,000, but millions of copies. And somebody said that to me that you have an enviable collection of wines, so it became a personal love for wine, besides being a professional love.
まあ、それで4000本ぐらい常になって、で、毎日毎日飲んでますから、減るんですけど、また買い足してるんですよね。だから本当に減ることがなくって、ずっとどんどん増える一方で、飲んでるんですけど、どんどん増えていくの不思議ですよね。まあ、そういう、本当に、漫画の世界で これをね、なんか世界中に伝えることができるようになってきて、まあ僕らにとっては夢のような世界話になってるんですけども、神の雫というタイトルがね、僕ボーンと降ってきた時に、まさかここまでね大きい漫画になるとは正直思ってなかったです。だけども皆さんのおかげで、なんか世界中にあの漫画読まれてドラマにもなり、これからもいろんなことが起こると思うんで、ぜひ楽しみに待っててください。
Absolutely true. We have a collection of about 4,000 bottles and we drink them every day. But while we drink them, we keep on buying bottles of wine. And so what is incredible is that the collection is increasing, although we are drinking this wine. The fact that this manga has become an international and even world sensation was a dream for us when initially I thought about the title we could give it, The Gods of God, The Drops of Gods. I didn't think that it was going to become so great over time. And this is thanks to all the readers and all those who saw the manga version on the TV. And please be informed that we have other projects and maybe other bottles of wine. And later on, we shall ask questions to Yuko. And always concerning roots, well, I wanted to ask Mr. Stevanato, your grandmother created a glass-blowing company, and you instead have a listed company even in New York. So what is your bond with the Venetian region, with a glass-blowing workshop? My grandfather started in Mestre, and then it moved where we are based today, where we have now our headquarters. We develop our strategies there in order to embrace the whole development of the pharma industry in the next decade. And we built a very strong culture, and so this is going to remain the throbbing heart and culture and head, and we have the ambition of conquering the international market. So we tried to use the classic recipes of our granddad, but together with my brother, we try to select very strong people who help us look into the future for the next decade.
Well, talking about perspectives and outlooks, these two ideas can go hands in hands. In terms of outlooks, Professor Rinaldo, in terms of perspectives, you have concerned us a little bit because it's not the first time that you say that your hometown, Venice, visited by millions of people, can I say, is it at risk? Well, of course, in 100 years from us, the average level of the sea will increase by at least 1 meter. Some people will say, oh, yes, but the reality is that this is going to happen. And the climate change is our fault. And therefore, with 1 meter more in Venice, the city will rotten, will go into pieces. There will be no lagoon anymore. And also the movable barrier to protect the city. I mean, this is a theme that took us 60 years to solve. If the problem of Venice was to get a defense from high tides, it was evident. Therefore, today, when we know that in 100 years from now, the future of Venice is totally unknown, we have carried out research efforts through Cultural Institute when Mr. Draghi was our prime minister. The feeling is that rethinking Venice, rethinking the water defense of our territory or the problems of drought are themes that have to generate a collective awareness that this is an urgency, this is an emergency, and indifference is lethal. If we go to other continents, you have mentioned Africa before, where the problem is is really the shortage of water, and people talk about the need to indeed take into consideration that migrants migrate also because of humanitarian catastrophes and droughts. Well, Africa is the symbol of our own liabilities for a thousand reasons. An expert who used to be the economist correspondent from Nairobi says that in 10 to 15 years from now, 800 million of Africans will live in cities that today do not exist, where it's very difficult to be here in the north of the world to say that those who begin to live a little better should deal with exhaust gases, etc. We're not credible if we order them to do so. In my opinion, resolving problems and solving the problem of greenhouse gases in Africa is not feasible. Let's talk and think about Murphy's Law, and let's think that this is going to happen. Let's look forward and let's see what we can do to adjust to a situation like this. Venice can become a case study vis-à-vis the rest of the world when faced with a climate change. This is a piece of jewel. This is not the Andamans or Bali where you can transfer people, etc. I heard that, you know, in a matter of a few years, some areas will disappear completely. Let us not sit back and wait. This is what science tells you, but we're not doing it. From Rakhshan Banietemad, what does roots mean for you? Persian culture is dating thousands of years back. It's a very important culture. What are roots for you? What is the meaning of roots?
Le radici sono
roots
l'insieme
are
delle,
indeed
delle culture,
the mixing of different cultures, traditions, the languages of peoples who make the indisputable core of a civilization which cannot be indeed crossed out and cancelled out. Professor Cannella mentioned the word language among our roots. I'd like to show you a symbol of language, the schwa. The schwa. This is another symbol. You can see it here on the screen. How do we define it? It's not it's just a phonetic symbol, which, according to some people, would be put at the end of each word in order to get rid of the gender. Not masculine nor feminine. So there is a strange sound in this schwa. Are we going to see it in the dictionaries? Well, it is defined. It is a word with a Jewish origin, which means nothing, really, if I remember well. And through the German language became schwa, and we have recorded it in our dictionary as a proposition, because schwa in actuality is a phonetic symbol which has been used in dictionaries as well in some cases. For instance, if memory helps me, in the Neapolitan local language, or English, it seems to me, computer, that final part of the word you would not say. Or in Neapolitan, mammut, Yeah, some people say schwa has to be uttered as Neapolitan. Yes, but Neapolitan is a language with its own structure. In a dictionary, we mention it as a proposition in order to overcome issues of gender identity and not to use the so-called non-mark masculine as much as the star visitor. And I personally do not use it. The chairman of the Society of Crusca here in Italy says that it is against the use. We should see in practice, in the future, a decision has to be made, because what guides a dictionary is the use of words. This is interesting, but how does a language change? Is it because everybody starts using a certain word? There was a terrible word, petalos, to indicate something soft. Well, it seems to be, it seems a bad word, because we simply are not used to saying those words. For instance, we have masculine and feminine genres in Italy. So language changes because the population starts using a certain word, isn't it? Yes. And then the lexicographer has to assess whether this new use has roots, can be confirmed over time as some sort of reasonable features. Our job is a little detached vis-a-vis the reality as it is, because we want to avoid to put into a dictionary such a term that only lasts for 6 months or a year. Petaloso was not a bad word. It was invented by a kid who loved poses. Indeed, petaloso means something which is made by poses. But that's a great deal of responsibility, trying to understand when a word is really trying to get into a society or not. It's a good job, believe me. Yes, thank you very much, Professor Cannella. I'd like to go back to our Kibayashi siblings and Yuko. I'm asking you, when you began to talk about wine and wine culture in your manga, what about the success? There was a good reaction from the general public or not?
好きか今始まったお話なので、自分たちと同じようにワインがみんなが好きかどうか分かりませんので、成功するかどうか最初は分かりませんでした。で、ただ日本の場合今インターネットでワインを買うっていう人がすごく多いんですね。それで私たちが最初にまず安いワインを素晴らしいと褒めた時がありまして、それをインターネットの酒屋が一斉にこう今始まったホットなワイン漫画がこんなこと書いてるって一斉にこう盛り上げてくれて、それで一気にこう知名度が高まっていったっていうのは、まず日本の国内での人気のきっかけになったんです。
I have to say that at the beginning, we didn't think that we were going to be so successful, but it happened that we loved wine very much, but we didn't realize how much the people around us could be interested in wine. We didn't know whether we were going to be successful, but what happened was that in Japan at that time, the internet was used for selling goods, including wine. And so within our work, we praised a wine which was very good and also had some moderate prices. And so on an internet platform, the information was given that the manga, our manga, proposed, suggested that wine, and so the popularity of our manga increased very much. Who
of you appreciates wine more, whether you like more white wine, red wine, French wines, or Italian wines. Be careful, beware of what you're going to answer. They are going to wander and try to be diplomatic. They knew the Campo Fiorin besides Amarone, of course.
あの、ワインっていろんなオケーション、例えば季節とか自分がこう嬉しい時とか落ち込んでる時とかで選ぶワインって違って、私イタリアワイン夏のすごい暑い時にイタリアの赤ワイン飲むのが好きなんですね。なんかこうイタリアの陽気さみたいなのが伝わってきて、なんかこう暑さが吹き飛ぶというか。で、冬の寒い時にちょっと一人で飲みたいなって時に フランスの赤ワインなんですね。だそうやってなんていうかこう生活のシーンに合わせて選んでいく好きなワインってその自分の気分とか季節とかそういうのと変わっていくので、そういうイタリアとフランスはそうやって飲み分けてます。
I need to say that for what concerns me, wine changes according to season or my mood, if I'm happy or if I'm sad, for example. For example, during hot summer days, I like to drink Italian wine because that wine makes heat go away thanks to its merriness, the luminosity of Italy and Italian wine. Instead, when it is winter, when I want to drink something on my own, perhaps I choose a French red wine. So, as a matter of fact, everything depends on the moment, on the season, and my mood at that time. And that's why you drink a different wine at different times. And you want to accompany that moment with different wines. So a big round of applause to the Japanese diplomacy. We just have a few minutes, and perhaps I want to ask a quick question on perspectives, perhaps in your field, with one word. When I say perspectives, what do you say? Opportunities, ambition. You are an entrepreneur, very rightly so. Keep on traveling since 1949 and keep on going for other decades. Mrs. Madam Banietemad, perspectives for your work or for your country, whatever you wish to say.
La speranza e il non perdere la speranza.
Hope and not losing hope. This is most important. Mr. Cannella, I think you're very right, madam. A big round of applause for her. Mr. Cannella, going on working to see how it goes. Yes, I'm curious. Mr. Rinaldo, well, to me, we have to be aware that perspectives are not the same for all. For example, the drought that hit Italy for many months and they cycle between drought and floods. In Italy, water was lacking and was requested a lot. If we look from above at the Sahel Desert, where it is over 35 years that it doesn't rain, and you look at it from above, from far away, you see the course of rivers that have, of course, dried up. So the perspectives are not the same for all, and good luck doesn't last forever. I also said so to the King of Sweden. You're full of water, but it cannot last. Oh, my goodness. And what are the perspectives for the brother and sister Kibayashi perhaps selling a lot more millions or increase their seller collection or other perspectives perhaps?
あの、前からあったんですけれども、非常にいいものができてきている。なんかそういう日本の漫画とか、あの、日本のそのワインとかを世界に紹介するようなこともできたら面白いかなと、今思ってますけどね。
Certo, va detto che adesso, sure. Ad esempio, anche in Giappone,
even in Japan,
essere prodotto del vino. E finalmente
wine is being produced, and it is some interesting wine. So it would be nice if in a close future we could introduce Japanese wine to the world. And Yuko, a question on manga. How do you create it? Is it more difficult to draw it, to create the script? And how do you distribute work?
あの、私たちはシナリオを書いているんで、シナリオの方が難しいと言ってしまいますけれども、あの、シナリオも難しいですけども、そのシナリオを、絵を描く人が、あの、解釈してくれるっていうか、そのお互いの関係性がすごく大事で、あの、そういう意味では絵を描く人の、もう難しいんです。でも私たちはシナリオを書くので、シナリオの方が難しいと言っておきます。
With screenplay, and so the most difficult part is the screenplay. But once you have done the screenplay, there must be an artist who is able to interpret exactly what we wrote. So it is very important to have the right relationship with those with our artists, and they, of course, the artists will say that it is more difficult to draw. Okay, a big round of applause for all our guests, because I think that the subjects were very interesting. And I move to the center of the stage, because now it is the time to give the Giorgio Boscaini plaque that the family reserves for those who worked for a long time and intensely for the distribution of products. So I would ask the chairman and vice chairman of the MASI Foundation comes to the stage. I know that you are attributing this award to people who helped value Valpolicella very importantly. Well, certainly, I have to say and I have to thank those people. And just I want to say that when you talk about sustainability, we mean ecological sustainability, but that is not the only one, but there is also a social and economic sustainability. Social sustainability is probably most important, the one that creates a change. So nobody of us, none of us can live on their own and create on their own and enjoy on their own. So I think the sustainability is the salt of our life, and we recognize all of in our cooperators the loyalty, in the true loyalty to what we think, to our culture, to our objectives, to share our objectives with us. And this year we want to give this prize to external collaborators who promote Valpolicella wines, Verona wines, and our own wines all over Italy, and they have been working with us for decades. And so the citation is for a long year collaboration with the Boscaini family and for contributing to the success of our products. I would like to welcome the winners, Mr. Arrigoni and Mr. De Blasis.
Perché una battuta va fatta, insomma.
Okay, the microphone, please. Well, I would ask the prefect, His Excellency the prefect, to come to the stage and give the award. The plaque is here. It is a plaqued bottle, and it is artistic. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you very much. I'm very proud. Thank you very much for this recognition. I would like to thank Mr. Sandro and the Boscaini family and all of Masi for being so close to us and for the support they gave us in these 25 years of collaboration. Thank you very much indeed. So the first plaqued bottle, Mr. Prefect, so this is the time of taking a picture. Here are the winners for the photographers. Thank you very much. We would like to thank Masi and the Boscaini family and share this award with the whole team of Masi Italy that works with us every day. And here is the second plaqued bottle. Sandro, Mr. Chairman, please give the plaqued bottle to the winner. Thank you very much. Congratulations, Mr. Arrigoni and Mr. De Blasis. Thank you, Mr. Prefect, for helping us with the awards. Sandro, please stay here because this is the award ceremony, the time for giving the Amarone bottles, which are a symbol of the barrel that the guests signed. And in order to, I would like to remind you that the Madame Banietemad didn't get into the cellar for the respect of her culture. So this is the signing of the barrel. It is an ancient ritual for buying barrels by signing them before you sell the wine in bottles. The wine was sold in casks, both in the Venetian regions, but also in Lombardy and other regions. And you know, the wine was transferred into the bottles when they went back home, and the sale was confirmed by signing the barrel. This is the wine I bought because I like it. This is a ritual that I remember from my childhood immediately after the war, and the guests or the customers used to come and, you know, have lunch with us. It is not like today we send an email and the deal is done. Now I would like to ask Mrs. Isabella Bossi Ferdigotti and Mr. Vigevani and the members of the Venetian Civilization Jury for the International Award, Mr. Cartellucci, and, you know, the respective juries. I'm going to move to the side because now the awards are going to be given, delivered, the Grosso d'Oro Veneziano to Madame Rakhshan Banietemad. Marco Vigevani is going to give her the award to Madame Banietemad, and the picture, the ritual picture, is being taken.
It's like the opening of a bottle here.
Grazie, davvero.
Yes, so thank you very much indeed. Hooray.
Adesso lo ricomponiamo. Grazie ancora, Rakhshan.
Thank you, Madame Rakhshan Banietemad, and thank you, Mr. Vigevani. Premio Masi for the Venetian Civilization, Professor Mario Cannella. Stefano Lorenzetto will award the prize. Thank you, Professor Cannella. Stefano Lorenzetto, here we are. It's a great pleasure to get the prize from you. I'd like to say something. We have to have a microphone. No, it's coming. It's coming. Now, today Giulio Nascimbeni's birthday, 100th birthday, will be celebrated. And he would say, Stefano, the only book you will go on reading is a dictionary. So, as they say in Naples, I have grown my family through words. 12 years ago, I went to visit the notary public of words, and we befriended, really, indeed, and I became free of charge one of his intruders, because I sent him messages of new words and some absence that I see when I go through the Zingarelli dictionary, etc. And this is a great honor. But the most wonderful word is save your life, because on November 29th last year, I diagnosed myself of an infarction. I drove to the Nerar Hospital, where my life was saved. After the magnetic resonance, the neurologist with some doctors and nurses, I was on the bed, etc., comes and says to me, you have a cerebral seizure ongoing. And I said, well, it's not very wonderful. In particular, you have the right part, the right area of your brain being hit. But you were lucky, because it hit the area of wording and not that of dictionary. And I said, well, as a collaborator of the Zingarelli dictionary, I really appreciate the fact that I've not been hit on the dictionary side of my brain. Well, thank you very much indeed. Now it's time for the official picture. The photographers must do their job. And congratulations once more, Mr. Cannella. Now, Premio Masi for Venetian Civilization to Professor Andrea Rinaldo. Mrs. Isabella Bossi Fedrigotti will award you the prize. Here you are, Professor Rinaldo. Congratulations. Thank you very much. Dear professor, so everything is fine, so thank you very much. So, Premio Masi for the Venetian Civilization is a Gruppo Stevanato, and the prize is being awarded by Mr. Paolo Possamai. They don't have a bottle, but they are being given a barrel as well. We have to remind you all about it. Well, thank you very much. It's a great honor. And eventually, the international prize, Mr. Stevanato, you can walk out. The International Masi Prize for the Wine Civilization to Yuko and Shin Kibayashi, and Mr. Sandro Boscaini, together with Federico Castellucci, are awarding the prize. Here we have, and a great round of applause to you as well. I really thank you, Mr. Wholeheartedly. As usual, I have to again talk to Mr. Sandro Boscaini, because we want to meet him again next year for the 43rd prize. And let's walk to the future. Tell me what you have in mind for next year. Early to say, but the members of our jury will work to find important, prestigious names. But there is something new. We hope that we'll be able to look towards the future. Thank you.